A major snag in the U.S. aviation sector. Nearly 9,000 flights were delayed and over 1,200 were canceled after authorities temporarily ground all domestic flights across the U.S. due to a Federal Aviation Administration system outage on Wednesday. The nationwide ground stop has since been lifted, but airlines warned of lingering delays due to ongoing congestion. Major carriers like Southwest Airlines, United, Delta, and American Airlines all reported 40% or more flight disruptions. The FAA says initial investigation showed a damaged database file likely caused the outage on the Notice to Air Mission System, or NOTAM, which sends vital information to pilots about flight operations. It adds, there is no evidence that at this time it is a cyber attack. The so-called durian diplomacy now at work. Chinese Ambassador Huang Xilian says locally produced durian that meet the import requirements can now have the same market access as Thailand, Malaysia, and Vietnam. Huang calls it a fruit of labor, following the state visit of Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. last week. The envoy also cited data from the Philippine Agriculture Department saying this development will generate over 9,000 direct jobs and over 10,000 indirect jobs. Marcos earlier announced Beijing's plan to import durian as the Philippines and China discuss ways to narrow their trade deficit. 3 years since being displaced by the eruption of Taal volcano, affected residents are still waiting for the housing units promised to them by the national government. Here's a report from ABS-CBN correspondent Dennis Datu, who was able to talk to some of the residents of the volcano island.
3 years since the eruption of the Taal volcano, majority of the affected residents are still living in makeshift tents. One of them is Raquel Seda, who can't help but remember their old house in Volcano Island. Aside from a decent shelter, Raquel is also struggling to make ends meet. She used to work as a tour guide at Taal Volcano Island, but her family now only relies on to the income of her husband, who worked as a construction worker. Another resident, Alan Andrade, a father of four, admits that he has no choice but to feed his family in the makeshift house. He cannot afford to rent a bigger house as his salary as a resort cleaner is not enough.
Kulang na nga po sir yung budget, pagka po kuha pa po kami ng babayarang bahay o kuryente pa o yung pagkain, tsaka po babaonin po ng mga anak ko kasi mga high school na po yung anak ko, kukulangin po. Ako lang po kasi yung tatrabaho sa kwan.
Over 130 families are still staying at the makeshift tents built under the municipal building of Talisay, which is under construction. They were not permitted to return to Volcano Island after it was declared as a permanent danger zone. These residents are now waiting for the housing units promised to them by the government.
May pangako po sabi na March po kami makakalipat. Sana naman po matugunan na po yung aming paglipat talaga. Gustong-gusto na po namin makalipat sa aming pabahay na sinasabi po.
According to the local government of Talisay, the National Housing Authority is fast-tracking the construction of more than 400 houses which has been delayed due to funding concerns.
Sa report ng contractor sa amin, ay na-delay ang release ng pondo. And hopefully with the intervention nga ng LGU, ay kami ay lagi nagpa-follow up sa corresponding agency, NHA, sa tulong na rin ng mga kaibigan natin sa national government, na tulungan kami na kagad ay mapondohan yung kakulangan para sa pabahay na ito upang sa ganun ay maibsan ang kalagayan ng mga kababayan namin dito sa Talisay.
Each housing unit has a lot area of 40 square meter and floor area of 26 square meter, which can possibly be habitable this coming March.
Ang commitment ng NHA at ng contractor, ng developer, ay by the end of this first quarter, March, ay makakalipat. Ito turn over nila ang 150 units.
As they remember the said unfortunate incident, affected residents hope they will commemorate the 2020 Taal volcano eruption inside their new housing units. Dennis Datu, ABS-CBN News, Talisay, Batangas.